Aplastic anemia. Aplastic anemia means there is no cells in the bone marrow. All the cells is forming in the bone marrow of a body. Okay. In aplastic anemia means HB, WBC, platelets, all are very low. There is severity like mild, moderate, severe aplastic anemia. So if you consider when all the three lineages are abnormal, so and there is no other abnormalities detected, so there is a provisional diagnosis of the aplastic anemia. Right. So how will the process, first we'll do the CBC, clinical examination, there won't be any finding.
Right, doctor.
So in aplastic anemia, all the three lineage will be at a lower levels. And we see the clinical examination, there is no other finding. We process with the CBC, where we accept the quantity of all the lineages are low in the CBC, otherwise no abnormal cells. So then we process with the bone marrow test. After doing bone marrow, we will see there are all the empty spaces, because the spaces, if we see in the bone marrow, are filled with the precursors at different level of maturation. But in aplastic anemia, this will be replaced by the fat. There is nothing inside. So this is the aplastic anemia. Aplastic anemia is a disorder that range from the youngest to the eldest of the person. So there is no age bar. So, but the treatment varies according to the age. So once we confirm this aplastic anemia, after doing the routine and the special test, we need to find out what is the age, because less than 40 years of age, having a good response to the stem cell transplant. So stem cell transplant, if the donor is available, is the treatments of choice in the aplastic anemia younger than 40 years. More than 40 years of age with not so very severe aplastic anemia, we can give a second option of antithymocyte globulin. So this is the second option. First is a stem cell transplant in younger generation, less than 40, more than 40 years, there is a antithymocyte globulin, because it is a fact that this aplastic anemia originates from the due to the killing of the own cells by the T lymphocytes. So this anti-thymocyte globulin depletes these T lymphocytes so that the destruction of the own body cells will be reduced. So that if there is less destruction, so the normal cells will able to have a good life. So that leads to the increase in the HB, WBC and platelet count. So this is the second treatment. If the treatment, third treatment is like for the people who can't afford the BM bone marrow transplant, ATG, third option is the medications. Medications like cyclosporine, immunosuppressive medicine, or danazole with or without steroids for a few days, we can add to see the response. If you see the stem cell transplant, it will have a response of around 60 to 80%, ATG 40 to 60%, and the oral medication ranging from 10 to 30%. So in aplastic anemia, stem cell transplant gives a very good quality of life. You can resume your work after 6 months if there is no complications, and you will be a like a normal other kid if it is done at a young age. Because in aplastic anemia, what happens, all lineages are problematic. So if the platelets are low, there are the bleeding episodes, the quality of life goes. When WBC count is low, then it leads to the various infections, hospitalization. So doing the BMT at a proper time reduce the requirement of blood supports, the requiring of hospitalization, that increase the cost, because antibiotics are the most costliest. If you see the hospital admission, out of the bill we generate, 50% bill is for the antibiotic. So the minimum BMT reduces this hospitalization and the extra necessary expenses. Yeah. Aplastic anemia is a disorder where it's a non-cancerous condition.
Yes.
But it's as dangerous as a cancer.
Right.
Maybe in few cases it's the most dangerous than the cancer because it doesn't have WBC and platelets. So WBC, low WBC leads to the frequent infections, and a platelets, low platelets as low as 1000 can lead to a bleed anywhere in the body, including the in your central nervous system, leading to the brain hemorrhages that can be massive, that can lead to a death as well. So aplastic anemia is non-cancerous, but as deadly as a cancer.